Hey boys and girls, it's Luca here, playing as Luca still on PokerStars, and I'm a member of PokerStars Team Pro Online. This is day 100 of Fixed Limit Hold'em Banker Challenge. Today we're starting with 611 bucks. I also updated the VPP count and the Stars Coins count. So we have 3,007 VPPs, basically from the start of the February, I guess. From the start of the year, I actually started to make on the February, so this is the current VPP amount. And we have 230k Stars coins in the bank, so that basically means that we have actually $230 of rake back in the bank. But I know I said many times before that I'm actually not gonna use this amount for my bankroll here. I want to complete the challenge with just a cash game table profit, no rake back, even though the rake back is just fine, and I always support people who are including their rayback in their bankroll, so I think that's the right way to go. This is actually such a good table. I'm gonna join here, even though I would prefer to play two tables of 1-2 and one table of 50 cents, $1. I think it's gonna be pretty good for the day. So here is I have one hand, so let me enable Hold'em Manager Graph, and of course we have a special guest today here on the live stream. It's Lemmy the cat, right? Yeah, he's a good boy. So let's hope he stays here on our live stream. Not gonna defend with King 8. So I said I need to let's see. Hold'em Manager Graph, right? Yes, that's what I was talking about. So let's see who will be modding your chat now if Limit Cat is here. I don't know. Not sure how to answer that. It's still gonna be Limit Cat, I guess. We'll see how it goes. Not gonna take this seat. So yeah, Hold'em Manager Graph. Yes, taking this table. Sorry about it, guys. Just trying to enable Hold'em Manager Graph here, and here is. So now I can actually start from here. This is actually a pretty good table as well, but I don't need one right now. So I think these three tables are going to be good. Two tables of 1-2 here in the upper slots, and one bottom left is the 50 cents $1 table. Now we can actually start for real. I guess it's a good. We had a good start here, and I should remove the blocker here as well. Well, that's a good flop. I mean. Setting, flopping a set is always good. Of course, it's a dangerous flop, so shouldn't be like too comfortable here. Calling once. I mean, I guess I could call once more. I mean, I'm not gonna have like million outs here, unfortunately. I did hit a straight now, so. But it's a four flush here, and he has a flush. Nice hand. I knew that's a possibility, of course, so that's why I wasn't like 100% confident in my hand. I think it was a good call. I had a gut shot, which I hit, and a jack on a 10 would be good as well. Ooh, well, that's now I think my hand is locked. Ooh, I totally forgot about the challenges. Thank God I actually hit a quad here and not full house, because I had a sneak peek on today's challenges, so I guess that's gonna be a bit of a spoiler for you. But I'll just open up the challenges windows right away, right after I'm gonna win this hand. And he actually hit a straight, so he's gonna be a bit more, I guess, a bit salty. He actually lost against quads, lots of quads in like last, I don't know, like 3 or 4 live streams. Oh, that's a big window. Let me get it a bit smaller. Let's have a look into these challenges. So today we are celebrating football ball. So football stars join PokerStars. So Football Inc. superstars Cristiano Ronaldo and Neymar Jr. become PokerStars ambassadors in 2015. So this is what we are celebrating today. Today, two challenges for today are the first one. Silver is win one cash game. Or zoom hold'em hand with a full house for a vendor reward up to 10k. And the gold one is actually to win 5 cash game or zoom hands with a full house for vendor reward. So this is actually perfect for today's live stream. I'm sure we're gonna get lots of full houses today. Well, at least I'm gonna get 5, I guess. So I'm just gonna start here. And I'm gonna do some magic here so that I can actually have this thingy here on the live stream the whole time. Let's see if I actually can get this to work. I want it for this to be displayed like I did the other day. So let's see if I actually can make it. I'm gonna call here. Money sped. I don't trust him at all. Carbonija call, so that's kind of worrying as well. We'll see. Maybe I can actually fault if Money Sped actually bets again on the river. So is he capable of bluffing? Yeah, sort of. I mean, I do have ace high. Carbonija call, cold calls. Can I actually fold this? I'm gonna fold the first hand. But now I'm fine. Now I'm done with folding. No more folding for me anymore. Let me just do the thing that I was just talking about. Let me just display the whole challenge here on the live stream here on my tables or on my desktop. Just give me 1 second, guys. And window capture if I do like this. Okay. Queen 8, yeah. Oops, didn't want to click on that. Sorry about it, guys. Now I know I'm blocking my own table right now. I mean, I can see it, but you can't. So yeah, something like this. I think that's gonna be fine. I think that's gonna be just fine. You can see it, right? I'm gonna fold this one and gonna bet here with my 8, which I think is gonna be for the nuts here, basically. I don't think he has a king here. He would do something with a king, so I can bet freely here. Like this, yeah. Okay, now everything is ready, guys. Now I can just, I mean, I don't know why I've started streaming here, but now I can actually answer your questions here. I see there's some talk here on the Twitch chat, so let's see who will be modding. Yeah, we know who will be modding. Klimika is here, but who wrote that down, right? Who wrote the bad fish, good fish, nice fish, losing fish, and all other adjectives down? I don't know. That's gonna be a mystery, right? You thought for the whole time that Klimika is actually writing this down. That's not gonna, I guess that's not the case today. I see Silesium here, he's on the table, and he's on the chat as well. So hey, Silesium, I guess you're gonna be tracking me down today. That's gonna be totally fine. Hey, Peter, Luca, where you play live poker? Do you have a preferred casino? Fixed limit, of course. I mean, I have actually never played cash games live. And certainly I haven't played limit hold'em live. So I don't have any preferred casino, really. So I don't really like live poker that much. I mean, I do play like a one or two, or I mean, I guess a handful of like live tourneys. But that's basically it for me. I mean, like I joined a national championship or stuff like this. But this is where live play ends for me. So the online play is so more comfortable for me. Basically, I mean, just because, well, you can just sit down here in your sweatpants if you want and just start playing here. You don't need to wait for the tables and nothing like that. So. And you don't need to sit in front of the table for like 7 or 8 hours straight to win the tournament at the end. So yeah, that's also a pretty good. So yeah, I prefer online. So pretty good start of the stream. Of course, we have We have Svetlo here, so he is my lucky charm for the last few live streams. So let's hope the trend continues. I think I can bet here again with my ace 10. It's gonna be, it's gonna be good most of the time. I guess I can go for a check call here. Let's see if he is like inducible or something like that. I mean, he could obviously have the best hand anyway. So I'm gonna give him a chance to bluff, and he took the chance and wasn't good. He actually bet with a queen high. Cool. That was a good hand. Money's bet here. I'm just gonna bet with my fours. Nunez. Now I can actually bet with an ace. Was always thinking that I would be folding this hand. I guess this is gonna be our last hand on this table. Because the table is breaking apart. I'm even gonna call here. I'm fine with fold. And I'm gonna quit this table and just try and find a new one. Let me update my graph. I had a pretty good start. No full houses so far, so haven't completed the silver challenge so far. Let me just update the graph. Let's see how we start our live stream. $27 in profit. Nice. Nice, nice, nice. So let me try and find a better table. I mean, I don't even mind joining the 1-2 table if I find like a really good one. But like I said before, I would kind of be okay with 50 cents $1 just because I kind of want to lower my variance here today. This is the previous table, right? Yep. I'm gonna go for a check raise. I think it's good enough. I mean, he like insta bets, I'm not sure what that means. Now, tomorrow is not empty stream. I'm gonna be streaming on Sunday, unfortunately. So my Saturday's live stream is gonna be next week, I think. I don't have time, unfortunately, tomorrow. So tomorrow, no stream tomorrow. But like I said, on Sunday. I know, I really want to do MTT stream as well, like the limit hold'em tourney, so I'm gonna have a look tomorrow if those tourneys even run. So we'll see if they run. Of course, I'm definitely willing to do live stream next week, but this week, unfortunately, like I said, no time for that. Can I 3-bet queen 10? I mean, I guess I could, but I'll wait to see how Nunez actually plays. And what I'm drinking, I'm actually drinking black tea with milk. Not drinking the beers that are displayed, obviously, that was for Speed and Go. Ooh, that's not what I wanted here. That was my chat. That's my chat. King 4, not gonna play. Still waiting for a new table. How about this one? Yes, I'll take it. No wrecks, it seems. I mean, at least not good ones. One unknown. Oh, that is a pair is unknown, and one Roxy, one green one. So I think it's gonna be good table. It's 1-2. Oops, not the green one. I need to the rear color. Yes. So plan for today is to make some profit at the tables. As you can see, I started with $611 here today, which is basically enough for 1-2. It's 300 big bets. So, we had some unfortunate live streams before, sessions before where I lost like majority of my $600, like 200. The worst one so far was losing $200 here on the live stream. That's 100 big bets on 1-2, which is. Well, if you have 300 big bets of bankroll management, that is 1/3 of your bankroll, so let's hope that doesn't happen today. I guess so far so good. Nunez, actually checks behind now. I mean, I guess I could see a call, but that queen smacks his range a bit too much, so I'm gonna fold my ace king here. If like anything else falls, I mean, maybe a jack. If jack falls, I guess I won't be calling there. But anything else I would be, especially obvious if there's a brick like a deuce or whatever. Mm, Gonna 3-bet here. There's always a chance that Roxy here folds, and it would be like the best case scenario, but didn't do it. He didn't do it really this time. But I flopped the pair, so not really worried about my hand. On a full house. Ooh, guys, we're gonna complete our challenge number one, the 0-1. Yay! Exclamation mark, not point, right? No, it's not exclamation point, it's check mark, exclamation point. I just got a ticket, unfortunately. So, yeah, ticket for the silver challenge. Obviously, that's pretty normal, considering that you get like a ticket in 77% of the time, I think. I think that's the correct number. But yeah, complete the challenge number one. Cool. The second one is gonna be, I guess, a bit tougher. We still need four full houses, but we're playing Limit Hold'em. So it means that, yeah, you're gonna get full houses quite a lot here in Limit Hold'em. So I guess my pro tip for today would be do the challenge in Limit Hold'em Zoom Pool. That's gonna be the easiest one. If the Zoom Pool is actually running, I think it is. I mean, the last time it was. Again, still to my surprise, it was running. Let's see how is it today with the Zoom. Yes, it's running, and there's like 47 people in it. Pretty good. So yeah, like I said, my pro tip. Do the challenges in Limit Hold'em Zoom Pool. I'm pretty sure it's like it's way easier to get five full houses in Limit Hold'em than in No Limit, so. And it's also you're playing the 10 cents, 20 cents tables, which is, well, you're risking way less than if you have to play No Limit 10, for example. If you want to compare like Limit Hold'em with No Limit, I guess you would take like 5 or 6x. So basically, if, for example, here my stake is $2, so if I divide this by, let's say, by 5, it's 0.4. So we are basically playing like No Limit 40. So yeah, this is the same as like No Limit, like 20 cents, 40 cents small bet and big blind in No Limit. gonna fold. Was thinking about to betting like for 1 second there, but nope. Now that now that Roxy here quits, and Silicium is here instead of him, I'm just gonna be, well, quitting this table pretty soon. Now Petty doesn't seem well, first he is not known at all. He's actually really, really tight. Like a need, so just gonna mark him with a pink color tag, and that's gonna be it for the table here in bottom left. I'm gonna cap here with my king queen suited. Rascal's early position race is pretty wide. Nunez, his 3-betting range. I mean, I would assume it's pretty wide, so that's why I actually decided for a cap here. Rascal actually folds the flop right away, which is kind of surprising. I'm gonna call once more, but just because I have such a good implied odds here. And the pot is obviously really big. I can't bluff here. He's never folding ace high, so maybe he has like 5-7. Nice stance suited, unfortunately. Yeah, he had a pretty good hand, so nice hand by Nunez. In the case of this, obviously, I'm just hoping that he's like a bit of out of the line, which this seems he might be, just because he seems kind of aggressive in general, so at least so far pre-flop. Ace-10, this is definitely an interesting flop for me and Silicium here. I would go obviously bet here. He did believe me that I actually have an ace. So quitting here. The table, and again in search for a new one. New table. Ooh, the 50 cents $1 one table I found is really, really good, and I'm actually first in the waiting list, so let's hope the table actually pops out here. So two out of five. Did I get a full house? Wait, did I have a full house here? Nope. Did you get another full house? I totally forgot. King 10 bottom left, yeah, that's the one that I want. Oh, right, of course, the ace 10 hand. Derpy derp. Now I am only one hand away, or three full houses away of completing the challenge, the gold one. And obviously I'm excited about the gold one. I haven't completed many gold ones yet. I think only two so far. Yep, only two. In the one I actually got $10. In the second one I only got a ticket. So I'm definitely excited for the third one. Just because I'm playing, like, I'm not playing Seed and Goes, I'm not playing Spin and Goes, I'm not playing the tournaments. So for me it's definitely way harder than for some of you guys to complete the gold challenges. So if like the gold challenges are like today, as we can see here, there are for the cash games. So that's the one that I can actually finish or complete. So yeah, happy to see that today. I guess I have to thank Ronaldo and Neymar. Gonna cold call here my suited ace. Loser Koki is gonna be not unknown anymore. I don't know. I'm thinking about cold calling here. I mean, calling here. The problem is that Silicio might be check raising here. He wasn't this time, so that's cool. The three, I don't know. The three doesn't play for me anymore, unfortunately. Even an ace. I might, you know, fold here. Hey, MG Quads, good morning. Well, it's, you know, it's not morning for me anymore. I mean, if it would be like 10 a.m. right now, you would be correct, but 4 p.m. it's... I am well awake here today. Even though I am kind of drinking like my morning tea, my morning black tea with milk. Wow, no way, my S high was good. Holy shit. Nice. I didn't expect that, to be honest. I guess I'm calling here once and just fooling now. I believe Nunez check raise here. Even though he seems like a really aggressive dude, he wasn't out of line so far, so I'm gonna believe it. And you're saying the limit cat is gonna fall off the TV? Yeah, he's pretty close, yeah. I have to kind of support him, right? He was, oh. Nah, he's watching. He's looking out of the window. Just enjoying the cars and whatnot. So we have a special guest in Limit Cat today. Six three is gonna fold. I could actually join the Zoom pool, like, just for the lols. Maybe to complete the challenge a bit faster. I mean, the problem is obviously I'm gonna play the 10 cents, 20 cents, which is something that is like 10 times limit lower, 10 times lower than what I'm playing right now, so yeah, it doesn't really excite me that much. Don't bet by Mandy Sped. I guess I'll call, hoping that Silicium doesn't raise here. Again, I'm still thinking that my ace might play, and here's an ace. I guess if money's bad, obviously, if he checks, I'm pretty sure I have the best hand. And if he bets, the question is if I should actually raise or not. I guess the answer would be yeah, just to kick Vladal out. There's a jack. I guess I can call, right? I mean, okay, that's fine, guys. I assume Vladal's gonna have a flush and... Money's bet is gonna have that cage jack, so nice hand. So he was calling the flop with 5-7 suited. You want to bluff the jack 10 on the rear, but wasn't sure the 10 rear would fold anything. Yeah, I think you're right. I think it was fine, obviously, with jack 10. Even though jack 10 is, like, it's a pretty good hand to bluff, I mean. You're not gonna win on obviously jack 10 ever on the showdown, but yeah. Yeah, let's raise. I don't like this table anymore. I mean, I have Nunez here, and that's all I have. second pair. I'm gonna make a standard c-bet here. Check raise by loser cookie. Not really that excited. I guess a gacha. I mean, problem is obviously drawing that to an 8 or a queen. I mean, not drawing that, but drawing pretty thin. My jack on 10, I assume they don't play here, so I'm just gonna fold. To my looks, oh man, I look so bad, right? Wow, do I really look that bad? I just wash my hair, so they're always weird when I wash them, so. Yeah, tomorrow morning put could work, yeah. For me could work, yeah. I'm still in search for a third table here. What's going on? Let's see. The table's out here. Yeah, I guess I'll be joining the waiting list and just see if anything pops out here that's gonna interest me. What about this one? You know what? Let's join this one. Like two unknowns and one who I know it's not gonna be a good player. So I think that's gonna be just fine. Oh, where's Limit Cat? Not here anymore. So the Limit Cat went to went back to his little computer so he can moderate my chat here. Cap pot here. That's not what I was hoping to see, unfortunately. With my fives. And check behind, so thank you for the free card, but I guess I'm done with the hand. I assume he's gonna be betting at least on the turn here, if not on the river. He actually has he actually flopped or not. So yeah, that's like the usual. Capping pre-flop and then don't checking behind it either means well usually means monster basically. Someone could also totally miss. I mean he could also have like kings or stuff like this. Who would be like scared of that ace? I'm gonna go for check raise now. Wow, well that's strong. That is strong, unfortunately. Fortunately strong, that queen is actually pretty bad as well. I'm gonna fold if you can believe it. I'm gonna fold my jack. Wow, holy shit, I'm folding a jack. Can't believe it, even I can't. Let me update my graph, no idea how I'm doing. I assume I did lose some portion of my profit here. Oh, $20, oh, actually it was $40 in profit already, wow. But I'm down to 20 right now. Still cool. Another full house here if I saw it correctly. So Gitski is gonna be pretty aggressive. I'm gonna go for a 3-bet again. And this time he didn't cap, so I guess that's a good news. And of course now Pavel all of a sudden down bets. I'm gonna never fall in here, obviously for my what I assume is gonna be my good six outer here. Of course, that's what I'm hoping to see. Maybe you're gonna check? Nope. Not checking, huh, Pavel? Well, I only played three hands with you today, so I guess I can fold. You did call. He did call on a small blind, so I guess I'll give him some credit for some good hand. Yeah, Limit, where are you? He went to sleep. No, I mean he went to moderating my chat here, of course. It's a pretty tough table here in bottom left. People playing pretty aggressively, 4-6. So he just bluffed it out. Just bet three times, I guess. Yep, raised. Pre-flop, of course, yeah, that's fine. I mean, that's fine. 4-6 seems kinda not the best hand to raise with, but I guess it's fine. It's not the table I was talking about before. Loser kid actually open raising caps. So let's see what we can do here with my ace high. The queen is obviously not the greatest but if there's only going to be one like face card, I am actually willing to call down. Getsuki actually check raises me, unfortunately. Again, I have a lousy pair of fives. I mean, it's going to be tough for me to call down, so I'm just going to fold right here. And we have the same hand, loser cookie. So he was like insta-betting here on the flop on turn. So his insta-bet doesn't mean much. Hey, Toma, welcome to the stream. Welcome back. You home already? Or are you still on the beach in LA somewhere? So people destroying, crushing my soul here in bottom left table. Everybody's excited for Toma to be back. So still on the two full houses so far. Like I got both of them like pretty fast here on in today's session, but now haven't got another one for quite a while. I mean for like 20 minutes or so. Still, this was probably the table that I was talking about before, but I actually have a pretty good one so far, so no need for a new, to be honest, even though, like I said before, these guys are actually crushing my soul here. I'm actually gonna just sit out here. You can actually see that, right? Ugh. Nope. Oops, didn't want to sit out. That is fine. It's all weird, so let's see. Okay. Ace deuce. Yeah, let's try to ice race. Let's see if he's gonna fold again. He folded so far, like every hand, and again here. So 30 hands for Smikion here, and he folded all 13 of those. I'm gonna bet once more, and I guess I would go for a check call on the river if he calls me again. Not gonna defend with 5-4 against Elysium, that is fine. Especially not against his under the gun range. McDeezer. He actually limps here, so let's try to ice raise him. Rascal gonna obviously gonna 3-bet here with my 8s. Getsuki again for 3-bet here. I need to flop something so I can at least have a look on the showdown against him for once. I'm gonna call here with my ace-10. I'm just gonna go for a 3-bet here. I think my 8s are gonna be good. I mean, he did call pre-flop, so that's always kind of dangerous, but gonna play aggressive here, of course. That 6 is definitely not something I want to see here. I might even go for a check call, because the problem is, if I bet, I can't fold if he actually decides to raise me with a top pair or something. So I guess I'd rather just check and call if he actually did hit that 6, but here he actually had his king. Just go back, jet lag as crazy, but good, thanks. Cool, good to hear that. I mean, not that you're jet lagged, but still. I actually didn't have, like, I was obviously in Bahamas for like a week, and I really didn't have like problems with jet lag, like at all. I don't know, maybe I was just lucky. I mean, it was actually the same last year, so, I mean, but I know I was only there for like 1 week, so not sure if you can get like jet lagged if you stay at one place only for one whole week. Thinking about taking this seat, to be honest. But now that Penton is here, I think he just came to the table like a few minutes ago. I'm gonna stay here for the time being. Unreal, well played. Quinte. I mean, so far, Getsuki, like I said before, he's kind of crushing my soul. Have I actually won something here? Ooh, I won with Ace-Jack and Ace-Deuce. Nunez Dong bets the flop. I mean, is this mean a 9? I mean, I have obviously just a lousy ace high here. I guess I'll just keep on folding here. God damn it. Folding way too much. Way too much. King 9. Madizer limps again. We know he's like, he limped like the second time so far, but I know his stats are actually pretty tightish. Oh, he actually folded. What? Limp and fold. You didn't see that much. And even he calls who CMC Kinnon. He actually like folded the first 18 hands of on this table. And now he actually actually calls once. And Magdizer limps again, so let's just keep on raising here and let's see if he's actually capable of folding again. I don't think that's gonna be the case. That would be a bit too much. Oh, he actually went for limp and raise. And Silesium is here again, so I guess I'll be quitting the table now. No, not yet. Not yet. The table is still pretty good. I mean, it's not like the greatest now. Now that, the pointer chip here at the bottom actually, like Gietzky said, like hit and run. I'm gonna call with my A6. I'm not gonna raise or anything like that. I'm just gonna call down. Well, now I'm actually, now I actually won't. Oh, and now I actually will be raising. I assume his limp and raise actually did mean something here pre-flop. He actually had jack, so I'm gonna make a note that he, well, he's capable of limp, fold, and of course limp, limp, raise, jack, jack. Yes. Magdizer is all in. I'm just gonna use a, like, I don't know, like a light blue color deck for now, so tight. Tight and passive. Let's just call. The King 9, I mean, I usually call this against good players, but yeah, why not against Powell as well? Gonna call once here. He should be kind of afraid of this board, right? And he's not, I guess. I don't know, I'll fold. I'll give him credit. Gonna go for a check raise here with my top pair. As usual, jack 9. I don't know. I kinda don't feel like 3-betting here today against these guys. Check raising and betting 3 times. Is Vlado gonna call me with a worse hand? Nope. Just saving a look here in the lobby. Still searching for 3 more full houses. I'm gonna play until 9 p.m. today, so that means for 4 more hours. And I'm sure we're gonna get some full houses here in the next 4 hours, so not worried about it at all. Did complete the first challenge, by the way. Did complete the silver one, but only got a ticket. I'm waiting to suck out hard, and then I can leave. That's mean. That is mean. But I know you wanna like you wanna be on television, I guess. On television. Well, that's a good flop. It's not a full house, but I like it. I mean, I guess I'll go for 3 bet, but oh, 3 caps here. I'm gonna puke. Thinking about capping here, and yes, I will. I will. Nunes is gonna be aggressive, so and he did actually went to race. So nice hand by Manny's Pets. Oh, wow, he hit a 3 at the end. Oh God, I said I'm gonna cry. Let's cry. Really? King 3? Oh, come on. So Silesium is waiting for to suck me out, so I guess I won't be betting this one. Loser cookie actually goes for I guess I'll go for 3 bet. I just want to play aggressive here with my kings. Or for me to win and call me hit and run scum, yeah. Ace Queen by Loser Cookie, so I guess I could put in like a call on the flop and raise on the turn, but yeah, I'm fine with that. I'm fine with the way that I played. Freaky weirdo. I'm not going anywhere with my ace high. Still not going anywhere. I'm kind of expecting some checks behinds here from him. And now I have a pair, so... And when you have a pair, you don't fold in the mid hold'em, right? And now he's gonna show me like ace 10 is gonna be salty here about my 4. Ace queen. Uh-huh. He's not a happy gamper right now. I stopped the play here on upper left. Gonna pre-bet Nunez. Gonna go for a... I guess I'm gonna go for a check raise. Bet and 3-bet, I think that would be pretty fine. Flat 10 is not the greatest, but gonna continue, of course. And crying call if he raises. Poker phrase mug, yes, I like it. 10 euro, no, 5 euros in a shop in Croatia, in Pula. Best buy ever. So freaky, where did he call me down? He did with jacks. Kind of loose call, if you ask me. I guess like, I don't know. It's kind of loose call for. I think at least against me, I know. Well, I'll fold. I'm gonna quit this table. So freaky, where did he bets again? I have like 2 overcards here and a king and a 10. I don't know. I can call for either king or 10. Let's do it. I don't know. Doesn't seem that great, but you never know. And I think I'm gonna fold. Maybe a king queen I could call, I guess. Probably not. Silence. Let's do a bit of silence. Let's see if Paul don't bet here. Does not don't bet. I'm gonna go for a check raise here with my force. I guess the good news is that, well, unless he has a 9 here exactly, he's not gonna raise. Well, maybe I was wrong. Giving him credit? Yes. Now he quits. No, he didn't suck me out. Suck all of me here. No. I'm gonna 3-bet here with the king jack. So I hit a 7 here at the end, so it wasn't a full house. Nope, he actually hit a queen at the end, so I was good throughout the whole hand. So I think that's a good news, right? Freaky bird calls, like the board is like really bad for my hand, so yeah. Yeah, I'm gonna check fold here. Check fold and try to find a better table, a new table actually, not just a better one. Any table will be good right now, I think. Oh right, I was actually on the 50 cents $1 table here. And I am gonna take the seat here and just bring the table back. What happened here right now? So let's like this. Yep, let's continue here. I know I'm playing on 2 50 cents one table, but the sooner I get 1-2 here in, I'm just gonna quit upon of this, so it's gonna be perfectly fine. Oh, I'll just go with a queen 9. I'm gonna go for winning my check raise here. I'm gonna go for check raise. Yeah, I think that's fine. Here's 1-2 table. If it's any good, I'm gonna... I don't know, not convinced like 100%. No, you really made a bluff there with when I had force. What did you bluff with? No way. Homer Simpson fake ID card, West Hollywood gift shop. So that was yours best buy in US. Both these guys call here. I just want to see a flop here, but I guess... wow, he had tens. I still have some outs. Ace wasn't one of them. Unfortunately, I'm just gonna go for a check raise here. Check juice, so... Ooh, I actually have full house. Nice. So, I mean, I haven't won the hand yet, I guess, but... pretty close. Well, at least I didn't, at least I didn't hit a king here for quads. Like I did, like, at the start of my session. He actually had aces, so... yep, that was good. I am only one away from... oh, no, two away. My math day is, like, just totally off. Two away from completing the gold challenge. Right, it's like a pretty weird dynamic on the tables, I think. I don't know. Let's refresh my graph. I have no idea how I'm doing. I mean, I think I'm still up. I think I'm doing okay-ish. Oh yeah, actually, 42 bucks. Well, so I guess Svetla is still here, so that's why you had queen 10 there. I mean, the problem is that obviously I'm not check raising like bluffs there. So I was thinking that you actually have a legitimate hand because it doesn't make sense to bluff there, but I guess I just leveled myself into the fold, so nice hand. You wouldn't check raise flop with fours, why not? I had also four of clubs. And you did open raise from middle position. I mean, if you would do it from the under the gun, I actually don't mind not check raising there, but you did open raise from middle position. Like I said, I did have four of clubs as well. I'm gonna call once here. Check him high and king high. Good? No, probably not, right? Wait, it is. Cool. Yeah, I can't bet. Nope. Can't do it. Hi Mod, hi Dad. I'm in TV and I act like a total jerk. One flip face. So this table is filling up, so let's see who these people are. Geron, I guess the last time I beat him with a King 5 against Aces, so maybe I can get lucky again. That's a pretty good turn. He actually bets right away. I'm gonna go for a check raise and let's see. Yeah, I don't even mind a fold. I'm fine with a fold. I don't think he's bluffing here. A7, not gonna do it, this guy. Orbit. Pattern fold. Am I capable of doing that? He really went for check raise. I mean, I'm not good enough to fold here. That's oh yeah, the nuts. Nice hand. Surprised he actually went for a check raise with a flush. Obviously, people like this, people like him, just don't bet the river. So I'm just gonna make a note on that he is check raising flush the river. That is fine. Nice hand by Orbit. I think going for check raise here is gonna be fine. Queen two is gonna fold. So I am playing for 48 minutes only, so still a long way to go. Now I have the top pairs of the top pair here against Orbit. Can I get some of my money back? Dio seems like a good turn card. Can bet a fold? No, this time not. This time I'm gonna check. This time I'm being pussy, I'm gonna check, and he has 6-3. Nice! Nice. Checking behind here with my ace as well. Deciding what to do on the river. I assume he's gonna bet he has like a really big aggression factor. He actually checks, so that's actually not the best news, I guess. I mean, unless he has, I don't even know what he could have, so I'm gonna check behind. So hoping that my ace is gonna be good, but it's not. Not gonna defend here, so pretty good chance for a full house here. Now I actually flopped a set. Nope, he folds right away. Oh right, I'm still playing on 50 cents $1 table. Totally forgot about that. Maki Maki actually went for a raise. I'm gonna call and raise a turn. He actually folds. So Maki Maki is playing kind of weird in general, so. Wow, 10 and 9 by Harry Hurry. Ugh, come on. Come on! I'm not gonna ice race with force, even though I could do it, but. Don't want to tilt in the very next hand. Thanks for stopping by, Silicium, and thanks for being a jackass here on the table, so. And I'll see you some other day. And of course, I'll stop by on your live stream as well. Check raise by Panton. Ugh. Can I fold right away? I'm folding way too much today. Folding way too much, but it doesn't seem that I'm folding in the right spots. Orbit open raise, so I'm gonna defend with my king, queen 10, of course. I could even fold right away. I don't think I'd even need like a. I don't even need to peel here. I'll fold. I usually would peel, but eh. Check 7. I think his open raising range is wide enough for me to check raise here. Should be like a big problem. Richman, obviously I would play with him quite a lot lately. As you can see, we have 600 hands in my database against him. He's basically here every time, almost every time when I do live streams. And he actually went for a race and a bet on 3-bet. He's not believing me, or he just has a too good of a hand. Wow, he checks behind, really? I'm not gonna call if he bets again on the river. He has like an ace-king or something? Deuces. I'm giving way too much credit to these guys. Yellow-black, just gonna go for check raise. Pretty simple, obviously. Oh, yellow-back. Did I say yellow-black? It's yellow-back. So playing only one table of 1-2. Wasn't my plan today, but this is how it goes. I'm gonna force 1-2, of course. If they're not suitable tables, but they are. They are suitable tables, just can't get a seat being on the waiting list and whatnot. Let's defend against Ricky Weirdo here. I gotcha the 2 work cards, doesn't seem that bad. Well, not Orbit actually raised, but I'm gonna. Cold call here. I mean, I could even 3-bet, but I don't think Freaky Bear is gonna be like folding like 2 over cards here. So I guess 75 cents. That's the price that I'm gonna need to call here. I mean, to bet here in order to see the river, and I'm fine with that. A6, so I have some outs. 10 wasn't one of them, unfortunately. I'll call here, and he has a flush. Lots of outs here for V88 Witz, of course. Hey, Kubalinho, thank you for the follow. Welcome to Mirror's Mafia. Mirror's Mafia, when we only min raise, as you'll probably notice pretty soon. And spoiler alert, because we're playing Limit Hold'em. No holding button here. Check behind here by Richmond. I mean, in the previous hand he was bet-3-betting with deuces, and now all of a sudden he's checking behind here. Guess my sixes were good. 8-9, so he's capable of just slowing down if he actually misses. I could even make a note on that, to be honest. I'm not gonna 3-bet here orbit. I'm fine with just fold. So can I make a note on this guy? So 3-bet, like 9-8 suited, and don't check back. Nice, queen X missed. Flop and then check turn in river. So I'm just making note that he's not even betting, like he's not even bluffing the turn river, so he doesn't seem to be, I don't know, bluffing, I guess. Even though his aggression factor is pretty big. I mean, obviously if he's betting 3-betting pair of deuces on jack 9-9 board, his aggression factor is gonna be pretty big. Hey Gameflow, welcome to the stream, welcome back. Still searching for two more full houses to complete the gold challenge, as you can see here in the bottom right. Completed the silver one, only got a ticket, unfortunately. I mean, unfortunately. Ticket's also pretty good, obviously chance of winning something big. You never know. Hey Upos, welcome to the stream. Can you give me $1? Really? Nah. No begging, unfortunately. I mean, no, I don't mind begging, but the problem is obviously that there's so many ways to like earn $1 here on PokerStars or any other site you want, that you just don't need it really. If you just put your mind into it and just play some free rolls, even for just for fun or whatever, you can definitely get like $1 to play with, even more of course. So I think there's lots of chances to get your, well, I guess a starting bankroll or whatever. And you can always play for play money too as well. I mean, if you like poker, I can't see why couldn't you play for play money as well. But welcome to the stream as well, of course. I meant in the chat. 6-5. Min raising for the win, yes! Min raise Mafia! Here's 1-2 table. If this guy wouldn't be out here, I guess I could take the seat, but yeah. Richmond 3 bets again. Pretty aggressive, pretty flop so far, Richmond. Even though I have like a note on him. Oh, he's like, wow, he's really aggressive today. So if I obviously double click here on my hold'em manager, I only get stats from today. And he is, well, he's really aggressive today. He actually continues here on with a bet, so I'm gonna call. I mean, I also have a gut shot, so why not? He's gonna check, but I can't bet here. I mean, his bent shoulder is not that big actually for someone who is that tight, but I don't think he's gonna fold like ace high. So that's why I'm not even trying to bluff here. 3 bet by Orbit. I did hit a flop, so just gonna bet here. I'm gonna reach, but I'm actually gonna give him a orange call tag, which just means that he is like a taggy. Seems to be a bit more tagging than like a rock or whatever. Can I 3-bet here? I think the answer is yes. I wouldn't do it with King 9.